I, yes, you, you're a star. Literally. Let me explain by starting at the very beginning. When the Big Bang had just happened, the only elements in our hot, dense universe were hydrogen, helium, and trace amounts of beryllium and lithium. But don't we require oxygen to breathe? Our blood has iron in it and our bones have calcium. So where are they? Well, life didn't begin when the universe was created. No. For life, we need stars. Stars are formed from stellar nebulae, huge clouds of gas and dust that come together due to gravity. Before it's a fully grown star, it's called a protostar, which is a clump of gas and molecules that might eventually become a brown dwarf or successfully become a star. In its first stage, it's called a main sequence star. This is because what keeps the star living is a delicate battle between the outward radiation pressure of fusion and the inward pressure of gravity. This fragile balance between the two competing forces is called hydrostatic equilibrium. All stars fuse hydrogen into helium for nearly 90% of their lives. For an average-sized star like our Sun, the temperature and gravitational pressure at the core won't be very high, so the star can kinda chill, taking billions of years to run out of fuel. When it's nearly done, the hot core will shrink, and the extra energy pushes the surface of the star outward. It is now a red giant. As more of the outer layer, or planetary nebula, is pushed away, what is left in the middle is the white dwarf. Let's talk about massive stars. Bigger isn't always better, as their lives are much shorter, although definitely more exciting. As they run out of hydrogen and their core shrinks, temperatures are large enough to fuse heavier elements in smaller time periods. For this star, the main sequence lasts a mere 7 million years. Then, helium forms into carbon, carbon fuses into oxygen, which fuses into silicon, then iron, and then boom! The star collapses within 1/4 of a second in a brilliant, bright supernova explosion. This is because iron cannot be fused, so gravity wins! But wait, there's more! The extreme temperatures and pressures cause the creation of elements heavier than iron, with higher atomic numbers. Uranium, gold, mercury, silver, zinc, phosphorus, sulfur. And all of this is spewed out great distances in the magnificent supernova explosion. After this, the star might become a neutron star, or if the core is even more massive, a black hole. So human life originated from the stars, but not until the supernova stage. This means that a star had to die for you to be born. So, if you ever feel bad about yourself again, just remember that you are made of star stuff.